Can I help you?
I should have come earlier, but I didn't know what to do.
Sorry, can I take your name, please?
Mary Painter, Mary Painter.
And what can I...
My daughter's been kidnapped.
All right, let me just get this straight, Mrs. Painter. You reported your daughter Jan missing last week.
8 days ago, when she disappeared. I'd only just come out of hospital.
Right, and then last night you got a phone call.
Yes, she sounded terrified. She said she wanted to speak to Colin. That's my husband.
And that's Jan's father?
A stepfather. They say we have to pay a ransom or we're never going to see her again.
And when your husband spoke to Jan, did she say that she was being held hostage?
She was crying. She said she'd been forced to phone.
What stopped you from contacting us last night?
I know. I was in two minds. But we thought if we went to the police, maybe they'd hurt her.
Don't worry, you've done the right thing here.
Only, it's just... I think I might know who's got her.
What do you mean, Mrs. Painter?
Well, Colin doesn't know that I found out, but I think maybe he's being threatened. I work one day a week at my husband's office, and the secretary there told me. She said that someone had actually come into the office and that they were yelling at Colin, but he didn't want anyone to know, especially me.
Do you know who this person was?
She said his name was David Tate, but... I don't know why he was having a go at Colin.
When your husband spoke to Jan, did she say how much they wanted?
£1,000. He has to pay it at lunchtime today.
Kidnapping is Area's domain, Jack.
Yes, but AMIP aren't going to get here in time, are they? It's 11:40 now.
Yeah, and if anything goes wrong, we might have a dead teenager on our hands.
But he's going to make the drop at lunchtime, roughly between 12 and 2, so we can't hang around waiting for AMIP.
All right, I guess you have to do what you can.
On my head be it.
Oh, yes.
John, get over to Mr. Painter's offices and take Mary Painter with you because you're going to need her to point him out.
Sir.
Any joy, Tosh?
Well, there's no David Tate on our record, sir, but there is one in the phone book. Mayola Avenue.
She's 15, you see.
Nearly 16. She'll be doing her GCSEs this year.
Do you mind if we keep this for a bit?
No.
You know this phone call? Was there anything in the background? Anything that might tell you the sort of place that Jan was calling from, like heavy traffic, building works?
It was evening, night. I was so taken aback. There was music, I think.
What kind of music?
Music? I don't remember. I'm sorry.
Mrs. Painter?
No.
You can't afford this ransom, can you, Mary?
That's not a problem. Colin's an insurance broker. He's doing really well. He doesn't have to know, does he? What I told you? Oh, that's him. That's Colin with the briefcase.
Just coming out now. All right, Alan, on your way. You could do with the exercise. Is it all right if I drop you here then, Mrs. Painter?
Yeah, I suppose so.
He's waiting for a bus, Sarge.
That's very public-spirited of him. There's a 40 coming along, if that's any good to you.
That's the one.
Well, if it is Tate, he's going to have to move pretty soon to receive the money.
Maybe Painter's bringing it here.
Nah, it's a bit naff. Hello?
Ticket, please.
Stay north, Sarge.
Ticket, please.
Police number.
Yes, sir. Ticket, please.
Look. You happy?
King's Head, Sarge. Plenty of room for parking for you.
Yeah, I have noticed.
I suppose it's a bit difficult to collect a ransom when your foot's in plaster.
Happy families. They're not all going to be holding her hostage, are they?
I better have a word.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah?
Do you live here?
Who wants to know?
Well, I'm DC Lyon's son, and Mrs. WDC Croft.
No, I live here. Why?
Oh, we're just making some inquiries about burglaries in the area, Mr.
Tate, David Tate.
Could you spare us a minute?
I know that bloke with the machine. 10 to 1, it's him.
What's his name?
I can't think.
Well, it's not David Tate because he's at home. Josh is with him now.
No, I know. It's not Tate.
It's not very handy, then, is it, if he recognises you?
It's hardly my fault, Sarge. Anyway, I don't think it's registered.
Right, I'll keep an eye on that bar. You cover this one.
OK.
Nice one, Alan!
Doesn't seem to be any access from your garden to the neighbouring gardens, Mr. Tate.
No. Which neighbours have been burgling?
A couple of doors down.
I hadn't heard.
Yeah, well, thanks for your time, Mr. Tate. Off work, I take it.
Yeah, I fell out of a tree.
What, course, Grumpy?
I'm a tree surgeon.
Oh, bad luck. Still, your firm being short for that sort of thing, weren't they?
No, I'm self-employed.
Oh, dear.
Let's go.
Right.
Meadows is going to love this.
Look, just leave it, will you?
Why don't you admit you cocked it up?
Oh, you're making it out to be all my fault?
He recognised you, didn't he? He knew you were old Bill.
So why give him the nod to go after him then, Sarge?
Yes, Cathy.
It's Barry Sparks, isn't it, Sarge? Done for theft, and if I'm not mistaken, unlawful sexual intercourse.
What if Sparks had been innocent? How do I explain an unconscious man in hospital?
He had the money in his holdall.
But you didn't know that.
He did a runner, Gov. We had to chase him.
He recognised you, Alan. It should have been John who was up front.
He's been convicted before, so we know where he lives. It's the same result as if we'd followed him to his flat.
If he goes back to his flat. Conway wanted Amipin. I said we could handle it on our own. And now all I've got is an unconscious suspect and no sign of the girl.
We could try Sparks' flat, sir.
We will. But a minor villain turned kidnapper, I just don't believe.
What about the USI charge?
Unlawful sexual intercourse was never fully established. I reckon he's a runner for somebody.
What about this Tate character?
There's no sign of the girl at Tate's house. And we checked with BT and no phone call was made from his house to Painter's last night.
Well, he wouldn't keep a hostage in a house with a wife and 2 children. She'll be somewhere else. Go back and suss him out, Tosh. Up front.
OK, sir.
We may be running out of time. John, turn Sparks' flat over now.
Right, you do the bedrooms, we'll take the living room and the kitchen.
Sarge.
Man's well up this, don't you reckon?
Yeah, I'll go and check the other one, Kev.
Right. You got anything, Ellen?
Nothing at all.
Who are you?
Hi.
Come in. I said, who are you?
Who am I? I'm the police. Who are you?
I'm Peter Sparks. It's my brother Barry's place.
Yeah, I know.
Where's Barry?
Well, he's in St. Hugh's Hospital, unconscious.
What?
So has your brother had a girl staying here in this past week?
What do you mean, is it St. Hugh's?
I said, has your brother had a girl staying here in the past week?
No. Barry hasn't had a girlfriend for months.
Sarge?
Cathy? So, your brother's fond of pink, then?
And there's a rail card and a library card in there, both in the name of Janet Painter.
Thanks. Try again.
Maybe he found them. I don't know. I don't live here, do I?
Where is she?
I don't know what you're talking about. Now, what's happened to my brother?
I don't give a toss about your brother. Now, I want to know what's happened to Jan Painter!
Mary, we agreed not to go to the police.
She did the right thing, Mr. Painter.
Oh, really? And what if something's happened to her?
Colin!
We may have put her life in jeopardy.
Look, I know you're only trying to do the right thing for Jan, but the police know more about this sort of thing.
Have you ever heard Jan mention a Barry Sparks?
Never.
Who is he? Do you know anything about him?
We have dealt with him before, yes.
What's happened to her? He's done something to her, hasn't he?
If she's lying dead in a ditch somewhere, it's going to be your fault.
Mr. Painter... Mrs. Painter, we don't know if Jan's been harmed or not. But if we're going to find her safe and sound, we really need your help.
Yes, of course. I'm sorry.
Right. Do you know a David Tate, Mr. Painter?
Colin! Please! Tell them!
How do you know?
Celia at work told me. She said he's been threatening you.
I didn't want you to have to worry about that.
Is this true, Mr. Painter?
Yes, it is.
Why has he been threatening you?
He was a client, self-employed. He paid me for some personal insurance, but I didn't set it up. I'm not surprised he's angry. When he broke his ankle, he couldn't make a claim. He's got no work, no income.
So why didn't you insure him?
Well, that's what's so stupid. I just forgot I was... Things have been so difficult lately.
What kind of threats were they, Mr. Painter?
He said he had violent friends. He wanted money.
Did he mention Jan?
I'm sorry, Mary. I'm so sorry.
Why did you deny knowing Colin Painter?
Because I'd been threatening him, hadn't I?
Threatening to do something to his stepdaughter?
No!
Jan's purse and her sweater were found in Barry Sparks' place. You're in this together.
I don't know Barry Sparks!
You're lying about knowing Colin Painter.
Yeah, all right, but I don't know Sparks!
You demanded money off Colin Painter.
He ripped me off! How do I support my wife, my boys? This leg won't mend for 6 weeks!
So you threatened him with violence?
He owes me money!
And you also threatened to harm his stepdaughter if he didn't pay up.
No! I said I had some friends who could get physical, yes.
Barry Sparks being one of them.
No, I never heard of him.
But you do know Jan Painter?
No! Look, why should I do something to his kid? It was Painter that owed me the money. I denied knowing him because it's threatening behaviour, isn't it?
Well, there was no phone call from Tate's place to Painter's last night, or from Barry Sparks' place, so where was she phoning from?
Do we let Tate go, sir?
No, we hold him on threatening to assault for now, but we keep on digging.
DS Bolton. Right, thanks for letting me know.
Barry Sparks has woken up, sir.
I've never heard of a David Tate.
You're not smart enough to do a kidnapping on your own, Barry.
Kidnapping? You must be joking.
No, we're not. We don't find it remotely funny. Now, what have you done with her?
I don't know her.
Then how come her stuff was found at your place?
Bird and me brothers. He uses the flat as a knocking shop. Still lives at home, see?
Where were you last night?
What's it to do with you?
I don't think you realise the seriousness of the offence.
What offence? All I did was find a bag in the bog of a pub.
Then why'd you do a runner?
Thought I was going to get mugged.
You recognised DC Woods, didn't you?
I could sue you for intimidation. It's your fault I got knocked over.
If you don't know Jan, how come you knew your stepdad was going to drop the money?
I just found it, right?
Look, son. If you didn't abduct her, then you're in it with someone who did. Either way, you're going to be on the inside looking out.
Now listen, you little toe rag. If you've done anything to that girl, if you've harmed her in any way...
Oi! Come here! Stop her, will you, police! Oi! Come here!
Come on.
All right, thank you. Calm down. It's all right. What are you running away for?
Get off me!
I think we've got ourselves a kidnap victim, Sarge.
You what?
Jan Painter.
Oh, don't be silly. Get back into bed. There's a good boy.
So, what were you going to do? Tie the sheets together and climb out the window?
All right.
She your girlfriend?
Might be.
She's 15.
So?
It's called unlawful sexual intercourse.
Prove it.
You've been had up for that before.
Wasn't proved then either.
How old are you?
27.
So whose idea was it?
What?
To say she'd been kidnapped. I mean, you are working together, I take it. She hardly looks like the terrified victim of an abduction to me.
I don't know what you're going on about.
Whose idea was it to extort money from Mr. Painter?
Not mine.
So, Jan, you phoned up your dad?
He's not my father.
Your stepfather, and you told him you'd been kidnapped. And that he'd have to pay money if he or your mum wanted to see you again.
No, I didn't. He's making it up.
And why would he do that?
I didn't say I'd been kidnapped. I'm really gonna phone from a pub and say that. It was packed. There was music blaring. Who's gonna believe I've been kidnapped and taken to a pub?
You phoned from a pub?
Yeah, the Green Archer. Didn't you hear the music when I phoned?
We've been worried sick for a week. What do you think you're playing at?
I never said I'd been kidnapped. He's making it up.
Did you ask your stepdad for money? You didn't think twice about forking out a grand for your well-being. Obtaining money by deception is a serious offence, Jan. Now, whose idea was it, yours or Barry's?
Barry had nothing to do with it.
I don't understand. Why didn't you just phone to say you're okay?
I wasn't okay.
Jan, what do you mean?
Did you demand money, Jan?
Well, why not? I deserved something after what he'd done to me.
What?
He's been after me. Getting into my bed at night over this past month.
This isn't true!
Yes, it is. Ever since you've been going into hospital for those tests.
You can't be serious. Not Colin.
Oh, that's right. That's all you care about, Colin. Mr. Dependable. Nothing can
get in the way. Jan, stop it! You should have told me.
Why? What would you have done?
I won't stand for anyone hurting you. I know you're angry with me. I mean, I should have seen. But of course I care. You're my daughter.
Yeah, right.
Are you alleging that your stepfather sexually abused you?
Yes, I am.
Oh, I thought they'd both be with you.
They're at the station. Jan's still under arrest.
Obtaining money by deception, is that it?
Can we come in?
Yeah. She is all right, isn't she?
Oh, she's fine.
Who was her hoax, then?
Mr. Painter, did you notice anything odd about the phone call that Jan made last night?
No. Why?
You didn't notice any sort of noise in the background?
I don't recall.
You see, Jan made that call from a pub. She claims that she didn't say that she was kidnapped.
I see.
She claims that she said she'd tell someone that you'd been sexually abusing her.
What?
She's alleging indecent assault.
No. No, that's not true.
You made up the story about the kidnapping, didn't you, Colin? You had to tell your wife something after that phone call.
No!
And that's why you didn't want your wife to go to the police, in case you got found out.
No!
Mr. Painter, did you make up the story about the kidnapping?
Yes. Yes, all right, but what Jan's saying, that's just ridiculous.
Oh, you're saying she made it all up, then?
I never had intercourse with her.
What did you do, Mr. Painter?
She started it. She provoked me.
She is under 16. Provocation is no defense, Mr. Painter.
But it wasn't like that. When her mother went into hospital, she was so helpful. Looking after the house, shopping. I was just so relieved she wasn't running rings round me, and then... I didn't mean anything to happen.
She's still only 15.
15 years and 10 months, but you've seen her. She's no virgin. She knew exactly what she was doing. Come up and kiss me goodnight, she said. Told me I didn't get enough attention. Thought I deserved more. Does Mary know?
Oh, yes.
Your mother's been waiting. We're ready to take a statement now.
About what?
The allegations you've been making about your stepfather.
You don't get it, do you? All I wanted was the money. I'm not making a statement in front of anyone. She spoiled it all by going to the police. He only dropped the charges because I did.
Look, Jan, are you sure you don't want to go through with this?
Sure, I'm sure. Can Barry sue you for getting him run over?
It's unlikely.
Pity. We need all the money we can get to set up home together.
Jan, you're 15. You're a minor. You've got to go home.
What's she still doing here? I told you I didn't want to make a statement.
Jan, we can find somewhere to live together. Don't worry.
Everything would have been fine if you hadn't gone to the police.
What?
I don't want to live with you, Mum. You must know that.
You don't have to make a decision now. We can talk about it. Please, Jan.
I'm sorry, Mum. I'm going to live with Barry.
It's technically illegal for you to live with Barry, Jan.
Oh, well. Okay, arrest me.
If your mother wants to make a complaint, then someone will have to come round.
That's fine, because if I can't go to Barry's, then I'll be on the streets. On the game. After all, I've got the experience now. Maybe you'd prefer me to do that.
Your husband's still waiting for you, Mrs. Painter, in case you want him to take you home.
I suppose I'll have to talk to him, won't I?
Do you want to stay in here?
Thank you.
Okay. I think Jan set the old man up.
I think it's called maximizing your potential.
She'll go far.
Yeah, well, maybe she deserves to.